I've traveled to the planet Earth to understand a concept you refer to as wartime propaganda. Someone told me to seek out Jimmy Dore. Who is this? Jimmy Dore is an extremely popular progressive comedian. Coming from a humble Irish-Polish background, he had 11 siblings. No wonder he's so far to the left. When you have 11 siblings, you gotta promote sharing or you starve. But Ma, 1% of us, took 99% of the mashed potatoes. Although he's a comedian, he's paradoxically a better news source than the actual news. With his cult following and his name, he brings back memories of that 1960s band, Jim Morrison and the Doors. Maybe because he helps you. Break on through to the other side. Break on through to the other side. He's best known for promoting the idea that the United States has too aggressive a foreign policy, using propaganda to keep the population in line. CNN and Fox News are like, I love they come a funeral pyre. Come on, baby, light my fire. Can you give me an example of a war like this? The WikiLeaks cables from the Bush administration clearly demonstrates that the United States sparked the Syrian war. There's leaked cables from the US ambassador to Damascus, William Rubach, stating that the US should overthrow the Assad regime by inciting violence between Sunnis and Shiites. The United States doesn't just care about money. The ambassador's only named Buck. Your name's money? You're hired. Who's going to be the next ambassador to Syria? I'm sorry, Rubach. We hired Blood Oil.
I am Alice, the alien's robot assistant, and I will read quotes from WikiLeaks so you can clearly distinguish between exaggerated humor and the US ambassador's leaked quote. Here is what he wrote. Play on Sunni fears of Iranian influence. There are fears in Syria that the Iranians are active in both Shia proselytizing and conversion of, mostly poor, Sunnis. Though often exaggerated, such fears reflect an element of the Sunni community in Syria that is increasingly upset by and focused on the spread of Iranian influence in their country through activities ranging from mosque construction to business.
So he wants to exaggerate fears of Iran to promote violence. Where have we seen this before? Who would have thought Arabs and redneck Republicans had so much in common? They could save money and send the same memo to Fox News. Now that's getting a real bang for your Rubach. People are strange when you're a
stranger. Faces look ugly. Both the local Egyptian and Saudi mission here, as well as prominent Syrian Sunni religious leaders, are giving increasing attention to the matter, and we should coordinate more closely with their governments on ways to better publicize and focus regional attention to the issue.
So then the Obama administration armed random Sunni insurgents so that they could incite violence and overthrow Assad. I can see why they put red all over the American flag, so foreigners bleed on anything. Oh, looks like that belongs to America. And so this is kept out of American media. As Jimmy Dore points out, not only is this kept out of the mainstream news, but anybody who dares to promote peace, they immediately label you a Russian asset. For example, Tulsi Gabbard met with Assad once to discuss peace, and immediately she's labeled an Assad apologist. Maybe that's why Tulsi Gabbard keeps a streak of gray in her hair like Rogue from the X-Men. She knows anybody she shakes hands with or touches, the media is gonna assume she's copying their power. Who is this woman? I believe she is a concept you call beautiful. Is she a porn star? No, but you'd think she was a porn star the way YouTube flags videos in support of her with an age-restricted notice. Here's the truth. Tulsi Gabbard is one of the only real Democratic presidential candidates because she wants to end the endless regime change wars. She's actually from American Samoa, which is a tiny island off the coast of the South Pacific. American Samoa actually has the highest US military enlistment of any state or territory. Did you know the Disney movie Moana was based off of American Samoa? No wonder she's anti-war. With the country's high military enlistment, she had to listen to Marines brag like, what can I say except you're welcome? For the tides, the sun, the sky. Hey, it's okay, you're welcome. Can you give me an example of media that tries to smear Tulsi Gabbard? The View is a women's talk show which had Tulsi Gabbard on to defend against Hillary's accusations when Joy, one of the main hosts, confronted her.
I'm speaking out against that.
And what's your evidence of that?
To change. Well, can I? Are you serious?
Let's hear it.
Are you serious?
Let's hear it.
I served in the war in Iraq.
Not you, her. You're saying that she's
exactly.
She's a warmonger.
I served in the war in Iraq that she championed. She championed a regime change war in Libya.
Did you not believe in that war?
I believe the lies that were told to us.
Well, so did she.
That's a ridiculous comparison, because in 2002, when Bush invaded Iraq, Hillary Clinton was a senator at 55 years old, whilst Tulsi Gabbard was 21. Nobody makes good decisions at age 21. Dude, on my 21st birthday, I was doing beer bongs with a hooker in Mexico that I later learned had a penis. Could be worse. I heard Tulsi Gabbard served in Iraq. How could she believe those outrageous lies? Although, if we're going to be discussing women's ages on The View, we should be talking about Joy, who hides her age of 77 with Botox and a facelift. I guess she had to get plastic surgery to be able to raise her eyebrows in surprise when she learns about Hillary Clinton's lies. Are any of the hosts of The View connected to politicians? Why, yes, we have Meghan McCain, who is the deceased John McCain's daughter.
Upset about this news that we are abandoning our Kurdish allies in the Middle East. These are allies of ours that American soldiers are still continuing to fight alongside. All we did was arm them, and they fought for America. And right now, we're just saying we're just going to leave them and abandon them. And to everyone in the White House and every Republican who was mad that President Obama pulled out of Iraq, you feckless, unpatriotic cowards. I cannot believe this is where we're at.
She's using words like feckless and coward, but it's not like she's the one fighting. The whole reason we went into Iraq was because we thought Saddam Hussein had weapons of mass destruction. Now she's calling me a coward, even though he's dead, and it's clear he doesn't even have weapons. And why are her ears so red?
He ran on isolationism, which again, I think is...
Even her own ears are embarrassed by her arguments. Her left earlobe's like, please, make it stop. And why is Meghan McCain so fat? John McCain wasn't fat. Her mom wasn't fat, so it's definitely not genetic. She's sitting back eating potato chips going, why don't you fight wars longer? Didn't we give you endurance training? You feckless bum.
Never saw a woman so alone, so alone.
We've got to have my twin call people fat, because as long as you're not conservative, YouTube doesn't count it as hate speech. Isn't that right, Bill Maher? She responded to other people calling her fat by saying, stop body shaming. The only body being shamed is the dead bodies of the people from the wars that you promoted.
He ran on isolationism, which again, I think is bat crap insane for a whole variety of reasons.
You think Donald Trump is an isolationist? That's funny, because I heard him say about ISIS, he'd bomb the shit out of them.
I'm gonna bomb the shit out of them. It's true. I don't care.
Maybe she didn't hear right, because her ears are so red. Oh, when I said Donald Trump is an isolationist, I meant that Iran was isolated with sanctions. The only one being isolated is the families of the dead soldiers that she promotes. Okay, I'll stop body shaming. Can you explain why her views on Syria and Iraq are wrong? Well, there's two separate wars that she's defending. In Iraq, we overthrew Sunni Saddam Hussein because he had weapons of mass destruction and installed a Shiite government. While in Syria, it's the opposite. We backed a Sunni group of rebels because we said they were moderate to overthrow a Shiite government. But the whole situation's backwards because the rebels that we armed caused mass destruction. So much so that Saddam looks like a moderate. I don't understand. Can you explain the point of this video down to a single sentence? In Iraq, Americans died to stop Sunni Shiite violence, while in Syria, we provoked it. Wow. No wonder that fat bitch's ears are embarrassed.
People are strange when you're a stranger. Faces look ugly when you're alone.